You know, the fundamental problem here is that headphones are a miraculous thing. You put on a pair of headphones and you get the same experience you get with a great pair of speakers, right? There's no such thing as headphones for video, right? There's not something I can carry with me that I can put on and it gives me the same experience I get when I'm watching my, you know, 50-inch plasma display at home. And, you know, until somebody invents that, you're gonna have these opposing constraints.
June 5th, 2023 is one of the most important dates for tech in this whole century. Apple announced a totally new product category, a thing they didn't do since the AirPods in 2016 and Apple Watch in 2014, so for almost 10 years. But I would argue that the introduction of Vision Pro is way more significant than those two, as they were already selling audio devices before AirPods, they just weren't wireless. And before the Apple Watch, if you're old enough to remember, my all-time favorite iPod, the 6th generation Nano, that I wanted to have so bad, was, as you can clearly see, an early prototype of what would eventually become the Apple Watch. No, this is on par with them announcing the iPhone, and there are really so many parallels. Both markets already existed beforehand. Phones like the Nokia, BlackBerry, and Sony Ericsson were all here and making massive sales. But they were either really dumb and with very little functionality, like the Nokia, or very complex and not intuitive to use, like the BlackBerry and all the other phones with a full-fledged keyboard at the bottom. And that's why the iPhone was so revolutionary for the time with the multi-touch. Even though that technology is so obvious to us now, the fact that the whole display could be used for everything, from typing on a keyboard and viewing messages to watching a video or pinch to zoom into a photo. And like the iPhone, this of course is far from the first AR/VR headset. They date back more than a decade ago with companies like Oculus that was kickstarted and then immediately bought by Facebook, or the Google Glass that was a very ambitious project, but like the other early adopters of some bleeding edge technology failed to succeed, simply because even though the vision they had in mind was so amazing, the hardware they were dealing with at the time just wasn't capable of delivering that vision into reality. And also, notice how you could either have an AR experience with smart glasses or a full VR experience where you don't see any of your surroundings. So that is the first way in which the Vision Pro is a game changer. It can be used for interacting with your environment and going through your house with it, although I am really wondering how often are you gonna start seeing these out in public, and how Apple is planning to integrate it with actually moving around. But actually walking through the city with these on is, as wild as it sounds, something that you should be expecting. So AR on one side, but on the other, why this is truly the first mixed reality headset is the ability to remove all the distractions and dive deep into whatever you're doing, whether you're watching a movie or working on a project. And you can really see Apple wanting you to use this a lot, because the digital crown on this device is specifically going to be for adjusting the level of immersion into the system. So you could be sitting in a very tiny room, but as soon as you turn the immersion level up, you could be on a beach or at a stadium or in space. So let's talk hardware. This whole design, as well as the internals, are so well put together. And in the words of Tim Cook, this clearly was years in the making, with more and more puzzles sliding into place for Apple over time. They took a lot of inspiration for comfort from the AirPods Max and its cushions and headrest. I can wear those for hours upon hours and don't feel any discomfort. So these will probably also be very pleasant to wear and will be snug on your face, since technically you will be able to wear this for a whole day while plugged in, but only for 2 hours on battery power. And that is already catching heat for being very short, especially considering the crazy $3,500 price tag. But I think that's just a reminder that it's only a first gen product, and there will definitely be improvements in the future. And I would argue that it's a good thing that the power supply is separate from the device, because could they fit the battery in the device itself? Probably. Would that also increase the weight and size tremendously? Definitely. Now, one more thing before I didn't go too far away from AirPods Max. I really thought this whole experience would be even more enhanced while wearing them together with the headset, since they look very similar, but I don't think you'll be able to wear them at the same time, or any kind of headphones for that matter, since the charging puck is right in the way on the side. So Apple, as they showed in the presentation, probably wants you to either use the smaller AirPods or this new surround sound system that I'm also very curious how it's gonna work. How much are the people around you gonna be able to hear it? And I'm guessing a lot, so does that mean that if you're in the office, you'll all need earbuds with the transparency mode to be able to work together in silence? There's just so many questions here. But the next puzzle, apart from the comfort, is the cameras and LiDAR sensors that bring the live feed of your surroundings to your eyes. So you aren't actually seeing anything, it's just this insane micro OLED display that has, in Apple's words, more pixels than a 4K TV. But I think that's actually an understatement. A 4K display has around 8 million pixels in total, while the Pro Display XDR, that is a 6K display, has around 20 million. Now this has 23 million pixels per eye. So just imagine shrinking the Pro Display XDR, that is $5,000 mind you, to the size of a postamp and having two of them, one for each eye. Are you starting to see why a $3,500 still isn't as bad of a price for a first gen device like this? So you can have a 4K display essentially anywhere you want to work. You just open up your MacBook and they pair instantly, because ecosystem. And then you can adjust the display size however you want, from a regular 24 inch display to a giant cinema panel. So when you turn down the immersion, you'll see a live feed of things and people around you. And they will also see where you are looking through this very trippy outside display that is showing your eyes. So you aren't actually seeing them, and they aren't actually seeing you either. It's just a feed from both sides. So how will they be able to see your eyes? Well, there is a totally different set of cameras and sensors around the internal displays that are specifically made for eye tracking, since it's an integral part of the UI. Apple is the first one that is doing this, and I think it's a very important component, since it brings back the human element of the interaction, even though it's not their actual eyes. But at the same time, come on, tell me we don't officially live in a Black Mirror episode. There is just something off while you're looking at it, and hopefully they'll improve it over time. And all those cameras and sensors that are constantly scanning your environment could not work if it wasn't for years of Apple improving the iPhone cameras. When it comes to photography, they're really neck and neck with Samsung and Pixel. And competition is really a good thing for us, the consumers. But if we're talking video, you know that Apple's been unbeatable for years. So combine that with LiDAR that came around 3 years ago on both iPhone and iPad, and the similar technology has also been used all the way back in 2017 since the iPhone X. Again, you really start seeing puzzles sliding into place one by one. So I really believe no other company could actually pull off something like this. And that brings us to the main point, the selling point. Actually convincing people that they need something like this, which is by far the hardest thing to do. That's why VR never really made it mainstream. No matter how hard companies like Meta tried to convince you, people just didn't see any value in having something like this. The software was never good enough, you always needed those controllers on both hands to interact with anything, and on top of that, it all looked very cartoonish and non-professional. And boy oh boy did Apple nail this. First of all, you won't need anything apart from your hands and eyes to control it. Your eyes are the cursor, and you select anything just by touching your thumb and index finger together. Also, for scrolling, you just slide in the air while your fingers are touching. It really works like magic. The other thing that no other company had is the ecosystem. This will, as I already mentioned, work perfectly with your Mac or iPad, so I pretty much won't need a monitor anymore. But at the same time, and this is very important, this device is meant to be used on its own, primarily. So there's two chips inside, the M2 for the actual computations, and the brand new R1, just for processing the insane amount of data from all the cameras and sensors. Also, another puzzle that came in the perfect moment, Apple Silicon. Without these ultra compact and insanely efficient chips, none of this could have been possible. I'm still using my M1 MacBook Air that is fanless and editing all these 4K YouTube videos on it with a breeze. Something like this was just unthinkable even 3 years ago. And as it's a product meant to be used by itself, they needed to build an entirely new operating system. You see how there were only Apple apps shown in the demo, and that's where the developers come into play. Apple always had way more developers than Android, simply because you need to optimize your apps for way less devices that all work uniformly. And also you're being paid more, so it's really a no-brainer. That's why the Vision Pro is coming early next year, which is not far but not that near at the same time. So the developers have enough time to optimize all the existing apps and I'm sure make some insane new ones. Of course, most of all, I'm very interested whether there will be a Final Cut Pro for it without the need for a Mac. And just the name Vision Pro implies that there will also be a cheaper product for a wider audience. But it's definitely not coming anytime soon, and it's anyone's guess how much will it cost. This is a first-gen product, but they sure did a great job engineering it. Will I be getting one of these? Well, since I consider myself a minimalist, and this would replace both my monitor and my TV, and improve my productivity, probably, most likely, yes, but it's still around a year away. What a time to be alive. It's 2023, AI is taking over art, coding, and writing, cars are driving themselves, and Apple Vision Pro will most likely be the first device of its kind that will start replacing smartphones with things like the virtual avatar, where you'll be able to meet with a friend in any place you like while consuming media on a cinema screen all from your bedroom. Really cool, but kind of creepy at the same time. Thank you so much for watching until the end. Part 2 of my last video is coming really soon, so make sure you subscribe for that. You can become a channel member or support me on my Patreon and visit my website. All those are gonna be linked down below.